Guys, Coaster Chal here, Doncaster born, but built for theme parks, and welcome to a Theme Park Newsroom update, where today we are looking at Six Flags Over Georgia. This is bigger than we first thought. Now, a fan of the channel called TJ, who's over in the States, sent me some pictures from the construction site, and trust me, it's been bigger and bigger. It is a bigger and bigger site. So I want to say a massive shout out to TJ for sharing with me the construction pictures. He also sent me a Google Maps image, basically sharing the site. And I'm going to share my thoughts on exactly what I think this is going to be. So before we get started with all the new stuff, please like the video if you've loved it. Comment down below your thoughts and opinions. Subscribe and click the notification bell so you never miss a YouTube video. We're on the road to 3,000 subscribers. We're almost at 2,900, which is unbelievable. I think it's 2,290, sorry. Bit confusing that. But no, we're on the road to 2,300 now. We want to try and get to at least 4,000 by the end of this year, or halfway through the year. So let's try and make it happen. We're also hitting nearly the half, well, a quarter of the way towards 700,000 views. Want to try and hit a million before the end of the year. Also, guys, check the description down below for social media links and also the Google Forms link where you can submit your own video ideas. And for now, guys, let's have a look at exactly what's going on with Six Flags Over Georgia on their brand new project, which looks like it's going to open next year. So shout out to TJ for the pictures of the construction site. There you can see work being done around the Splash Waterfalls site on these pictures, which is great to see. Now, obviously, we knew about this in the previous video. We spoke about that in a previous video, the fact that, you know, it's not, the fact that Splash Waterfalls have been sort of retired for about a year or two now. We knew it was going at some point. It's now officially been taken down. We saw the work taken around the back of Splash Waterfalls, taking all the parts down. The deconstruction team really is picking up the pace on site with this. And if we look on our screen right about now, you've got basically what a Google Maps image of what the site looks like and where all the development's been taking place. So this is a bigger site than we first thought. So it's taking up the Sky Bucket, which is the cable car. It's taking up the Bugs Bunny High Sea Adventure family ride, which is the Intamin Flying Dutchman, as well as Splash Waterfalls. And I mean, look at the space. Look at the site that could be for this coaster, which I think it will be. I think it will be a roller coaster. It's beside Splash Waterfalls. The marks on the ground near the track and the kids area and the trucking company have been removed as well. It could literally be anything. And this is going to be, you know, a really, you know, amazing attraction, whatever it is. And I'm really excited to see exactly what's going down at Six Flags Over Georgia for next season. So there we are, ladies and gentlemen, thrill seekers of all ages. That is speaking about Six Flags Over Georgia. Wow, this is going to look very, very exciting indeed. This is going to be a brand new project for next year, 2022 coaster, in my opinion. You know, Magic Mountain's getting their Raptor. I mean, there's a couple of things. It could be a Matt Power Splash. It could be a Max Force type coaster with that kind of extended blueprint of the layout. It could potentially be, maybe they could go with something different. Maybe it could be the premier coaster project that was rumored a while back. Now, if you you remember last year, we did a video on some late Six Flags rumors, whether it was for this year or next year, 2022. And there was rumors about how, you know, there was a few Zamperla family rides that were going to go in somewhere. There was three coasters rumored, a premier coaster project, a follow-up to Max Force, and a Raptor. I think a Screaming Swing was predicted as well. That was rumored in that article on Screamscape. So, you know, there's a lot of things rumored. So I think that maybe the premier coaster project could be coming to Six Flags Over Georgia, something like a West Coast Racer style coaster. And to be perfectly honest, I wouldn't actually mind this. I'd be a fan of that. If it was a Max Force or a Raptor or a Power Splash, I'd be a fan of all of them. But I'd also be a fan of a West Coast Racer style coaster, because I think that a Mobius looping dueling launch coaster for Over Georgia is brilliant. It's a perfect addition because it's something different and unique to the state as well. So and especially with, you know, Six Flags Whitewater down the road in Georgia, adding Python Plunge, which was delayed from last year and this year. You know, Whitewater's getting something and the park's getting something. So I think it's a big year for Georgia next year, especially with, you know, Funspot Atlanta getting their brand new RMC next year as well. It's going to be a big year 2022 for Georgia. Six Flags Over Georgia, Funspot Atlanta, and the Whitewater Park as well. And I'm sure Hurricane Harbor inside Over Georgia is going to be running well as well. But there we go, guys. Thank you very, very much for watching this video. Make sure you like, comment, subscribe, and for now, my name is Coach Chell. Keep living the coast of life, and I'll see you guys next video very, very soon. Take care, guys. Have a Six Flags-tastic day.